Runaways season is in a full speed going on right now, including its newest show to hit the stage, inviting audiences to enjoy a world of pure imagination. Charlie the Chocolate Factory is showing right now through December the 5th. Jennifer Ross is here. She's going to be breaking down the entire Broadway season for us. Hey, Jennifer.
Hey, Jennifer.
Hey, how are y'all?
Thanks for joining us.
Yes. It's been a long time.
Yes.
It has been a long time.
Good to see your face.
Thank Absolutely.
You.
Okay, so we've got new shows this season. What has the audience response been like?
The audience response has been really tremendous. Come From Away was our first show.
Yes.
And it was
so good. So
amazing to have full houses of audience members back after 19 months. Yeah. We were all thrilled. Our team was so excited to see so many people back in the house.
And I heard so many people had a great time at that show.
Yes,
it hadn't
really
heard
good.
Of it maybe, but once they saw it, they loved it. Mm-hmm. It was a great way, I think, to kick off the Broadway season this
well,
year.
Well, thank you. We got a little bit lucky with that show being the first one coming back after the pandemic. Mm-hmm. Scott and I both really loved that show, and we were so proud to be able to bring it to Northwest Arkansas.
Yeah,
yeah,
for sure.
Let's back up a little bit. The planning of the season, what does that look like? What does it take to put into planning a Broadway show season?
Well, we typically start 24 to 36 months in advance.
Wow, okay.
So right now, we're talking to agents about the 23-24
wow.
season.
Okay.
And we're looking at shows for the 24-25 season. Those are the shows that are on Broadway right now.
Wow.
And so we go to Broadway, we look at all the shows, we watch all the shows, we talk to agents and managers and producers, and talk to our colleagues who have seen the shows before us, of course. And then we just play the touring game with the mm-hmm. agents, and it's a big puzzle. So when they can fit on our stage and when the routing is right, then we get them in Northwest Arkansas.
And you bring us the best content. Mm-hmm. We love
well,
it.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Let's talk about what shows are left this season.
Yes, well, we're so excited. We love Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. The Oompa Loompas are my favorite, I have to say. Our next show is Mean Girls in December.
Okay.
It is based on the book and the movie, okay. So we're really excited about that. In January, An Officer and a Gentleman. In March, Hamilton.
Yes.
And in May, Fiddler.
Wow. It's a really full season for you mm-hmm. all this year. And it seems like a lot of them are coming back to back to back, at least right up now until the lead up until Christmas. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Really quick.
The pandemic played a big part in some of the spacing of
right.
our shows this year because we were trying to bring the shows back that we had booked that we didn't actually get to bring. And then with the agents trying to fill the seasons of those people who lost the shows.
Right.
So some of the timing is a little bit weird this
yeah,
year.
Yeah, but it's exciting. Yeah. I think a lot of momentum. So,
absolutely.
Jennifer, for you, are there any shows you're particularly excited mm-hmm. about?
I am really excited to see An Officer and a Gentleman.
Oh.
It is on a pre-Broadway tour. It comes from Sydney, Australia. A couple of years ago, Scott and I were at the Broadway League meeting in May, and the producer of that show, who is also the producer of White Christmas that opened here a
yeah.
few years ago, he asked us to come to a pitch for a new show that he
oh.
was working on.
Okay.
And this is the show. The creative team is stellar, and the music is fabulous. It's the music of the early 80s,
oh.
and so it's going to be so much fun. Rick Springfield, Pat Benatar, it's just going to be amazing.
Okay, so you mentioned 80s. I'm in.
I know.
Right? All you had to say
well,
was 80s
this,
music.
You know, little love story that
right.
kind of goes along with all the music.
But yes.
It's
oh,
really,
that's
really
it.
Thrilling.
But the music is going to be popular songs, right? Stuff that we know?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Absolutely. If you grew up or if you listen to the music in the 80s, from the 80s, it is absolutely going to be music that you recognize.
Yeah.
Ooh,
for
nice.
Sure.
So we focus on the Broadway shows, but I know you have a couple other kind of programs that you run there at Walton Arts Center, other shows included as well. Tell us a little bit about that.
Absolutely. We're really excited to bring back West Street Live, which is our Americana folk concert series in Star Theater. We also have the Starlight Jazz Club. Those are both in our Black Box Theater. We also have our 10 by 10 art series.
Right.
We have six more shows left on that series, including Jazz Wunderkind, Joey Alexander, and tabla master Zakir Hussein.
Man.
So, among other things, we have lots and lots of shows. Something for mm-hmm. everyone.
Yeah,
absolutely. There's always something for everyone at Walton Arts Center. So
yeah.
for our audience, what's the best way for our viewers to make sure they get the best tickets at the best prices?
Oh.
Where can they go to find out more information?
Absolutely. Best tickets, best prices, buy early.
Okay.
And if you can't buy early, if you're looking for a Broadway show, typically the Thursday matinees have really great seats available.
Okay.
So maybe, you know, take a couple hours off work and come to a Thursday matinee.
Yeah.
And really great seats, great prices. We also have a subscription subscription series. They've closed for this year,
okay.
But we'll be announcing the new season probably in March, and so you can jump on a subscription then.
Yeah, awesome. Absolutely.
At WaltonArtsCenter.org is the best place to get information.
Wonderful. Yeah. Jennifer, thanks so much.
Absolutely. Thanks for having me.
It's yes.
I love that tip about the Thursday matinee.
Mm-hmm.
We have to do that.
I know. I love that. Yeah. And I love the show's coming up. You got a lot of great stuff. Ready to see it.
Thanks. We're excited to see everyone at the theater.
Absolutely. Yeah. Stay with us. We got more Good Day in WA coming up right after this.